boy was I stressed when I was filming this for the first time. So all of the parts where I had more hair were filmed in panic mode. So now you have me to come and patch in all the details that I forgot about. Welcome back to part two in my veiling series, I guess. Today I'm going to show you how to tie a veil with the help of past me and this me. I am going to show you how to tie a veil with longer hair and sub in with some shorter hair bits, because the shorter hair bits don't really change how I wear my veil. If you haven't seen part one of why I veil and why people veil and veiling in general, definitely go and check that out. And if you're here to learn how exactly to do it, this is the video for you. So let's just jump straight into it, shall we? Take it away, past me. How do I put all of my hair into a veil or into a headscarf? Well, this is my hair. It's in a bun. It's nothing fancy. It's one of those buns where you make a ponytail and then on the last pull through the elastic, you just don't pull it all the way through. What I used to do is I used to make a full ponytail and then twist it and then keep twisting it until it like shrunk itself down and it would sit roughly about there. But I get tension headaches a lot more than I used to, so I don't do that anymore and it's a lot of effort. My arms get tired. Disability life. So I have like a big scarf. So I just kind of put it on my head like this. Nothing super fancy. To me, it doesn't matter if you can see this little bit of hair or not. Sometimes it just doesn't stay on my head, or if I pull it too far down, my eyebrows look like that. So I'm gonna go for about right there. The one that I usually do if I'm just veiling for a quick ritual is I get my two ends and then I just tie them in a loose kind of knot. I have a special scarf that I usually use for this specific headscarf tying, and it looks like that, and there's hair sticking out of it. This is not usually the scarf that I do this style with. I have like a nice little chiffon-y net thing. It's a lot thinner. I think when you stretch it out, it's about that big. This is this big, so there's a lot and it doesn't really work that well. But here is one of the ways that I do it. It's got all of my hair in the back, as you can see, and I can either put it over my ears or under my ears, depending on whether I'm wearing hearing aids that day. It's the easiest, quickest one. You can also twist the ends to make it a bit easier to tie. I just didn't do that. So another one that I do is I can just throw it over like that. It doesn't have to be super fancy. That works as a covering. It kind of depends why you want to cover your hair and what the weather is and what the wind is and what you're going to be doing with it. But this is also just a quick way, like if I'm feeling the immediate need to cover my head. This is usually what I go for, because you can do it with most scarves if they've got any length to it. Real quick, once again, it's over the head, and then you take this one and you pull it around to the side, and then you can twist this way. This is also the worst scarf to be doing this with, but whatever. So you twist. You can secure the end of this with like a hair tie or a bobby pin or a hijab pin, if that is something that you are used to, if you have on you, and then you just bring it in a loop, hand through the loop, grab the tail, pull with all your might, and then push up with this hand. Like that. It's not easy, but we've got a nice knot. Head is covered. That is not going anywhere. But there is also all of this length, which is why I don't really do it with the scarf. But again, not at home. So there's that one. I'm sure there are more. But those are like my go-to with this shape of scarf. Quits enough. I'll untie that later. So I mentioned, or maybe I didn't, that I don't normally veil in this scarf, which is true because it's just long and there's a lot of it. I veil in this one, which is the chiffon-y, netty one, and as you can see it's not as big and it's not as bulky, so it's literally just this length, which makes it much easier to just pop over my head like so. It's a little bit more flattening now that my hair stands upright. And then we just tie it there and tie it in a knot. And there's no like, there's no extra material that's getting in the way of the knot. So I can just very simply tie a veil like that. And then there's a tiny little flap here which just gets tucked in underneath. Just wherever it fits, it doesn't matter, it doesn't make it look any better at the back. Something that I also forgot to mention was wrapping the tails around your head. Some people don't like this, it can be a fire risk, and there are many, you know, it's personal choice. It can be for aesthetic reasons as well, and this doesn't fit what you're going for. So you could just bring it up, doesn't have to be any particular length. And then I just tuck it underneath the knot there, and then just pull this one over the top as well. And then you can just tuck this one either under the front, under the side, or in the little wrapped bits. Like so. With it being netting, it does kind of stick a little bit better. With something like this, there's probably the need for pins. Depending on your hair, I suppose. And something I completely forgot to mention in when I was filming the first time is if you do have a scarf that is wide, just fold it in half. Fold it in half. And that does exactly the same job like having a thinner scarf. So I can just easily, very easily, tie the knot in the back, not have to fight with it too much. I've now got many layers on. Which brings me onto my next point of if you are going to braid the ends, you can have more than one headscarf on to give you more tails. And you can wrap one inside, so let me just restart this one. Because it's also not even. Let's get this one back out. You can have one tail, which I'm going to bring around here because that's my dominant side, and keep one wrapped. And then you can, when the scarves are working in your favour, that's about half, pull that one over like so, tie a knot in it, you've got your two tails. Tug, bring that around the side. Now I have three of them and I can actually turn it into a proper plait, like so. And then if you want to be extra fancy, you can wrap that over the top when it's long enough. I haven't succeeded in getting it all even. But yeah, that can be a thing. If you still have a bun in the back, you can pull it further back. I don't know if you can see it. You can just wrap it around the bun at the back if length is a problem. There you go. That would be where a bun is, in theory. Tucking things in is your friend. So the next one that I have, and I haven't done these ties in a while, so it might not work, but I have this lovely scarf with all the cats on it, which we're going to use. So I'm going to fold it into a triangle. And then whip and just sort of lay it on top of my head badly like this. Grab these two, oh goodness, and I'm gonna start to tie a knot in the back. I'm gonna turn around, hold on, you might not be able to see any of this.
grabbing corners, crossing them over, tying a knot. There's the tail end. And then there's a triangle up here, which I'm going to push in underneath. And then tighten the knot. And then double knot it. Ta-da! It is not the best if you are aiming to cover all of your hair. This might not be the one. If you pick a bigger scarf, it might also help you, but it kind of, that's what it looks like. Sometimes if you've got like a really nice tight bun, unlike mine, you won't get as many flyaways. And then you have these cute little things down here. And it's not really going anywhere, but it is squeaking on my glasses. It's covering my ears, so hearing aids might be questionable. If you've got a large square scarf, you can fold it exactly in half. If you don't have a large square scarf, like I've spent the last 4 minutes figuring out I don't have, you can fold like a small triangle into the top and kind of hope for the best. So that's going to be the bottom side, that's going to be the side that touches my hair. This big triangle is going to point onto my foot. I could do this. I'm going to hold it in my mouth. I didn't tell me to do that. But I'm going to anyway. And then layer this on top of my head. Cross these over. And tie around the back of my head. Oh my god, I'm so sorry that you had to witness it like that. So, this is not graceful. It looks a bit better with like a plain scarf. And then you can just lift this bit up and tuck it in where they crossed over. There we go. That's what that looks like. It's a bit lightweight. It kind of gives you a little bit of volume. It's kept all of my hair in. There's the knot. There's the hair. There's some space in the top. I've never done it with this scarf before, so that was a struggle and a half. It's secure. It's nice. Not going anywhere. You can tuck it behind your ears, but the way I've tied it, I'm not going to. It isn't going anywhere really in day-to-day life, but you can just pull it off. You can just fold it in half, not do anything fancy, simple bandana style, and just, you know, under there or just around the back. In that first tie with this that I showed you where I pushed the flap down the back, you don't have to do that, you can just tie it as is and have like a long trailing bit, you know, Queen Elizabeth style, like this. Woot. Yeah, simple. It does depend on what you're wearing the scarf for and the purposes of the scarf. But yeah, that is how I wear a veil, wear a pagan veil, with my hair. And that's how I just sort of get it all in there and hope for the best. There are other pagan creators out there that talk about veiling and they wear different styles of headscarf to me. That's just personal preference. The other type of veiling that I forgot to mention because I didn't have it on hand because I wasn't in my house is a snood. Snoods are very, very easy to veil with. So you just wrap it over there, cross it over the front, and then lift, and then we have a covered head, and it should go over the back. If you're covering for modesty reasons or hair covering reasons, you might want to just pin it in the back or have I don't know what they're called, but like an under cap or another scarf underneath. But this is just super simple and super cozy because it's knitted, so this is like a winter going outside kind of veil, which I enjoy a lot. So I hope that this has been helpful to you in some way or another. Let me know if you try any of them out and how you find them. Don't forget to like this video, drop a comment down below, yada yada yada. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 PM UK time with at least one bonus video every single month. See ya!